On May 8, 2020, Chinese officials announced that Sun Lichun was removed from the post of Deputy Minister of Public Security. Sun Lichun was investigated by National Commission for Discipline Inspection in April for suspicion of serious violation of discipline and law. The information said that Sun Lichun's background in Western University is relatively rare among Chinese security officials. And after the official announcement that he was under investigation, there were rumors that it might involve leaking data related to epidemic to the United States, but it was not confirmed. So who is Sun Lichun and what were the portfolios that he was taking care of? Let's learn about the previous assignments of Sun Lichun. Sun Lichun was in charge of a highly sensitive area within the police force. He was handling the domestic security. In fact, he was the Deputy Minister of Public Security, which is the most important element of public security. And he was dealing with classified information relating to maintaining stability. And also as a public health expert, Sun was part of coronavirus investigation team that was dispatched to Wuhan by the central government. Now what is going on in here? We have to remember what's happening within Chinese Communist Party at present is a power struggle between the Xi Jinping camp or the Princeling camp or the Shaanxi province camp and the Jiang Zemin camp or the Shanghai clique or the business influencers that are closely associated with Jiang Zemin. In fact, the power struggle between the Xi Jinping camp and Jiang Zemin camp or the Princeling and the Shanghai clique came into light previous year when the previous leader, a former leader Jiang Zemin, party general secretary from the decade of 1990s, he sought medical treatment overseas so that he could be out of reach of current leader Xi Jinping. Now Jiang Zemin led China from 1989 to 2002, straight or just after Deng Xiaoping. Deng Xiaoping, as we know, was a reformer, an economic reformer, and Jiang Zemin was governor of Shanghai when he was elected unexpectedly to lead the Communist Party of China. So the policies of Jiang Zemin were more or less in continuation with the policies of Deng Xiaoping. In fact, he has been regarded by many as a counterbalance to Xi's influence on military and financial matters. Xi Jinping's loyalists have in fact accused Jiang supporters of trying to sabotage the current leader's regime, even going as far as to blame the Jiang faction or the Shanghai clique faction for the recent mass protests in Hong Kong over the controversial extradition bill. Now report says that 93 years old Jiang Zemin is undergoing state supervision. His doctors have been replaced without his consent and he is only permitted to choose between two hospitals within China. We must remember that in 2012 when Hu Jintao was a youngling, when he was relieved of the being general secretary of the party, he was not able to promote many of his loyalists. And the people that were promoted within the Politburo and Politburo Standing Committee were from Jiang Zemin faction or people who were earlier associated with Jiang Zemin and seen as a part of Shanghai clique. Now, on Sunday night, when Sun's purge was finalized, Public Security Minister Chao Ke-shi gathered the top leaders of the ministry to explain what has happened. Then he said that, and this was an inevitable, I'm quoting the words of Chao Ke-shi, an inevitable result of his long-standing disregard of the party's political discipline and political rules. His failure to observe discipline rules, awe and wanton behavior. Now this gives slight hint of a coup or a power struggle between the party among the Jiang Zemin supporters and Xi Jinping supporters. The meeting called for a pure police team, and we must resolutely remove the black sheep from the police team, the member said. Now we must remember another member from the public security was recently also met the same fate. He was Meng Hongwei. Now Meng Hongwei was the president of Lyon-based Interpol. He was under investigation and he kept two portfolios. He has a post at the ministry in China, and in 2016 he became the first Chinese head of Interpol, managing the agency's relation with its 190 members, countries and regions. Meng went missing during a temporary return to China, prompting his family in Lyon to report his disappearance. In the summer of 2018, China's political situation was shaken by a power struggle within the party. Now, the Xi Jinping camp launched counterattacks, which included enforcing strict official discipline within police organization that had not completely yielded to Xi's authority. Meng, who came for a visit to China and was held, he was ultimately sentenced to 13 years and 6 months in jail, a ruling which came 3 months ago, just before Wuhan was locked down. Meng and Sun were close to Chao Yongkang, who is China's former security czar, who was a Politburo Standing Committee member. And Chao was also sentenced to life in prison after being targeted by Xi's anti-corruption campaign. Now observe, every time anything like this happens, somebody is being investigated, it is in the name of anti-corruption. And Xi Jinping has quite a reputation or an image as an anti-corruption crusader. Meng also served Chao for years. Now, Meng and Sun became the first and second victim of crackdown on Chao's henchmen within the police organization. Now, the fate of one more figure is still in question. That is Chao Yongkang's successor as security czar, who is Meng Jiangchu. Meng Jiangchu is a former Politburo member. He's retired now, but it is widely known as being close to Sun. Meng Jiangchu belonged to Shanghai Fraction, a group of people who are close to President Jiang Zemin. And what happens to him would prove how this power struggle between the Jiang Zemin Fraction or the Shanghai clique and the princeling Xi Jinping turns out.